Assalamu alaikum. After studying the arterial pulse, now we are going to veins, and we are going to study what is the structure and what are their functions and how are their functions helped out. This is a previous diagram. You have studied it in lecture 1 on circulation. The veins are low resistant conduits for blood flow back to heart. They contain valves to prevent backward flow. Major reservoir of extra blood. They have got large lumen, so they are major reservoir for extra blood. They have low pressure in them and their walls are thin as compared to the arteries. The smooth muscles are present in them and they can change their diameter to a little extent. The contraction and relaxation of the smooth muscles occurs depending upon the needs of the circulatory tree. Sometimes you are asked to write down what are the functions of the veins and what are the properties of the veins. So the veins, they are taking away the blood from the capillaries through venules. It reaches the veins and then back to the heart. The systemic veins take the venous blood, the deoxygenated blood back to the heart, and the pulmonary veins bring the oxygenated blood from the lungs back to the heart. The veins provide passageways for flow of blood to the heart, and they are capable of constricting and enlarging as the blood reservoirs because they have got smooth muscle fibers in it, and they are supplied by nerves. The peripheral veins can also propel blood forward by means of a venous pump. It is not only that the smooth muscle fibers are going to help in constricting and enlarging the blood reservoirs. There are venous pumps present in the peripheral veins that propel blood forward into the heart. Veins also help to regulate cardiac output, and that you will be studying in detail later on. 1, 2, 3, 4 are the functions of the veins. At this moment, we are trying to follow the headings of your guidance. So, the veins, after describing their functions, there is a heading of venous pressures. What are the pressures present in different segments of the veins? Centrally, the superior vena cava and inferior vena cava drain into the right atrium. And the right atrium is actually, you can say, the largest vein that is draining into the right ventricle. So the central venous pressure is the pressure in the right atrium. It is called central venous pressure because superior vena cava ek hai, inferior vena cava dusri hai. Dono ko ikattha karke jab right atrium mein aana hai, to phir central venous pressure right atrium ka pressure hota hai. The normal right atrial pressure is about 0 millimeter of mercury. ये आपको लिखना याद रखना है क्योंकि हम इसके ऊपर MCQ बना सकते हैं चार पांच values देकर. The central venous pressure in the right atrium can increase to 20 to 30 millimeter of mercury, and that would be abnormal. The normal condition is 0. 20 to 30 is very abnormal, such as 1 and 2. Serious heart failure, when the heart is not pumping blood into the arteries, the central venous pressure rises. And number two, after massive transfusion of blood, if a person is having low blood pressure and an inexperienced nurse or quack gives multiple transfusions of blood, the blood is going to collect into the veins and then into the central vein, and that is going to cause increase central venous pressure up to 20 to 30 millimeter of mercury. It can decrease to minus 3 to minus 5. इससे थोड़ा नहीं होता. It can decrease to minus 3 to minus 5 millimeter of mercury below atmospheric pressure. कब? जब right atrium बिल्कुल खाली हो जाएगा, है ना? When the heart pumps with exceptional vigor after severe hemorrhage. अगर severe hemorrhage हो गया है, blood venous return आ नहीं रहा right atrium में, तो बिल्कुल ही खाली हो जाएगा, वो suck करने की कोशिश करेगा blood along with the respiratory movements, so that will decrease the pressure to minus 3 to minus 5 millimeter of mercury. Or when there is severe exercise and the heart pumps with exceptional vigor, बहुत ज़्यादा force लगा के जब heart pump करेगा, बहुत तेजी के साथ पंप करेगा और फौरन फौरन अपने आप को खाली करेगा तो राइट एट्रियल प्रेशर कैन गो टू -3 एंड टू -5 मिलीमीटर ऑफ मर्करी। इस लेक्चर को इस टाइम पर इसलिए भी अपॉइंट किया है कि आपने रेस्पिरेशन शुरू कर दी है और अब आपको पता है कि चेस्ट में रेस्पिरेशन के दौरान जो इंट्राप्लूरल प्रेशर है वो -3 टू -5 मिलीमीटर ऑफ मर्करी ड्रॉप कर जाता है बिलो एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर और उसकी वजह से राइट एट्रियम एक्सपेंड करता है और उसके अंदर भी प्रेशर जो है वो कम हो जाता है। अब ये राइट एट्रियम इतना ही इम्पोर्टेंट है कि इसके प्रेशर को रेगुलेट किया जाता है। कौन सी दो चीज़ें हैं जो इसे रेगुलेट करेंगी? द ब्लड कमिंग टू द राइट एट्रियम एंड द ब्लड लीविंग द राइट एट्रियम। वेन एवर यू ट्राई टू बुक अबाउट टॉक अबाउट होम्योस्टेसिस यू से इनपुट इज इक्वल टू आउटपुट एंड द होम्योस्टेसिस इज मेंटेन्ड। Whenever the input is equal to output, the homeostasis is maintained. So the output is the ability of the right heart to pump blood into the lungs, and that depends on the strength of the right heart contraction. The input is the tendency for blood to flow from the peripheral veins into the right atrium. So a rapid inflow into the right atrium will increase the right atrial pressure, and if there is no blood in the body, there is severe hemorrhage, there will be decreased tendency of the blood to flow into the right atrium, and that will decrease the right atrial pressure. So right atrial pressure is regulated by a balance between output and input. So now we see that the right atrial pressure can increase when the venous return increases, and the venous return will increase when the venous pressure increases, and that is helped by four items. One is if you increase the blood volume, more blood will be present in the veins, venous pressure will increase. Second is if you increase the sympathetic nerves activity to the veins, they will press upon the blood in the veins and the venous pressure will increase. Third is increase skeletal muscle pump. If you increase the contraction of the muscles, skeletal muscles over the veins, they will propel the blood to the heart, and this will increase the venous pressure. Fourth is inspiration movements. When a person inspires, there is increase in the size of the chest, there is decrease in the pressure in the chest, there is suction of blood into the great veins, and when there is more blood into the great veins, venous pressure increases. As simple as that. So peripheral venous pressure, central venous pressure कम होगा तो venous return increase होता है, इसी तरह peripheral venous pressure की अपनी importance है. Peripheral venous pressure is more when there is increased blood volume and also when there is dilatation of the arterioles. Arterioles जो है ना ये small blood vessels होती हैं जो कि arteries से arise करती हैं, आपको पीछे इसकी anatomy बताई हुई है, और ये आमतौर से इनका lumen बहुत छोटा होता है और इनकी जो wall है वो बहुत thick होती है. जब इनका ल्यूमन बड़ा हो जाता है ड्यू टू एनी रीजन जो हम बाद में अगले चैप्टर माइक्रो सर्कुलेशन में पढ़ने वाले हैं, जब आर्टेरियोल्स का ल्यूमन बड़ा हो जाता है, दिस डिक्रीजेस द पेरिफेरल रेजिस्टेंस टू ब्लड फ्लो, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट देर इज रैपिड फ्लो ऑफ द ब्लड फ्रॉम द आर्टरीज इनटू द वेन्स, एंड रैपिड इनफ्लो ऑफ द ब्लड वीनस रिटर्न is seen when there is increased peripheral venous pressure. Peripheral venous pressure increased by these two items. So this venous pressure has got different systems that are going to affect it, and first one is gravitational pressure. The gravity is pulling the blood in the veins downwards, and the veins are not as elastic as the arteries, and the veins are not as muscular as the arterioles, so there is effect of this gravity on the venous pressure. Gravitational pressure is actually the hydrostatic pressure of the blood. In the right atrium it is 0 millimeter of mercury, and it rises 1 millimeter of mercury for each 13.6 millimeters of distance below the level of right atrium. सबसे पहले ऊपर चलते हैं, देखें, it is zero here, and above the level of the right atrium it is in negative, minus 10 millimeter of mercury in the sagittal sinus, which cannot be collapsed. And after that, the veins, superior vena cava, internal jugular, external jugular veins, they collapse. So there is zero in it, and zero is in the right atrium. So as we see that the pressure is going to increase below the level of the right atrium, so here in the arm, at the level of constriction of the rib, there is pressure of plus 6 millimeter of mercury, and after that the pressure increases to plus 35 millimeter of mercury in the peripheral vein in the arm. The distance from the right atrium to the foot is greater in millimeters, and so plus 90 millimeter of mercury is the pressure in the dorsalis pedis. Have you done lower limb anatomy? If you have not done the lower limb anatomy, this is the vein, peripheral vein in the foot, and here you see the pressure because of the gravitational column is plus 90 millimeter of mercury. So now we are seeing the effect of high right atrial pressure on the peripheral venous pressure. Pehle humne kya dekha tha? Gravitational force. Ab hum dekh rahe hain ki agar हाई राइट एट्रियल प्रेशर ज्यादा होगा तो फिर क्या होगा. व्हेन द राइट एट्रियल प्रेशर राइजेस अबव जीरो, द ब्लड इज नॉट गोइंग इनटू द राइट एट्रियम, रादर इट बिगिंस टू बैक अप इन द लार्ज वेन्स. कौन सी है लार्ज वेन्स? सुपीरियर और इन्फीरियर वीना केवा. दिस एनलार्जेस द वेन्स विदाउट एनी इंक्रीज इन प्रेशर. सो इफ द राइट एट्रियल प्रेशर इज अबव 4 to plus 6 millimeter of mercury, what happens? The collapsed veins open. कौन सी थी collapsed vein? पिछली diagram में आपकी थी internal and external jugular vein, वो फिर open up हो जाती है. Then if there is an increase, additional increase in the right atrial pressure, हमने देखा है कि वो plus 30 तक भी जा सकता है. This causes a rise in peripheral venous pressure. So above plus 4 to plus 6 millimeter of mercury right atrial pressure, additional increase causes a corresponding rise in peripheral venous pressure in the body. And if the pressure is below plus 4 to plus 6 millimeter of mercury, the peripheral venous pressure is not noticeably elevated even in the early stages of heart failure if the person is at rest. So below plus 4 to plus 6 millimeter of mercury, the peripheral venous pressure will not rise. Even if there is heart failure and the person is resting. हम ये सब पढ़ क्यों रहे हैं? हम ये सब इसलिए पढ़ रहे हैं कि peripheral venous pressure अगर right atrial pressure से ज्यादा होगा तो फिर venous return अच्छा होगा into the right atrium. और हम ये देख रहे हैं कि venous pressures, peripheral venous pressures पर किस किस चीज का effect है. Gravity का हमने देख लिया, heart failure का, right atrial pressure के increase होने का भी हमने देख लिया, और अब हम ये देख रहे हैं कि अगर intra abdominal pressure ज्यादा हो जाए तो venous pressure of the leg को क्या होगा. This is not of the whole body but only of the leg. The pressure in the abdominal cavity of a lying down person is about plus 6 millimeter of mercury. So the pressure in the legs should be above 6 millimeter of mercury for venous return to occur in lying down position. In case of pregnancy, large tumors, abdominal obesity or excessive fluid in the abdominal cavity, there is pressure upon the veins from outside, and this will increase the venous pressure in the abdominal veins to plus 15 to plus 30 millimeter of mercury, and this will impede the drainage of blood from the legs. At this time, the pressure of the veins of the legs must rise above the abdominal pressure to open them and allow the blood to flow from the legs to the heart. अब आपको क्या करना पड़ेगा? ऐसे अगर सिचुएशंस हो जाती है तो हम कहते हैं टांगों के नीचे तकिया रख के सोएं या थोड़ा सा बिस्तर का जो फुट एंड है उसे ऊंचा कर लें. Thus, if the intra-abdominal pressure is plus 20 millimeter of mercury, the lowest possible pressure in the femoral veins is also about plus 20 millimeter of mercury. क्योंकि वहाँ तक जमा होता रहेगा, जब plus 20 millimeter of mercury पर हो जाएगा, तो फिर वो abdomen में से गुजर सकता है. अब हमने ये देखना है कि gravity हमें तंग कर रही थी, हमारे blood को वापस नहीं जाने दे रही थी into the heart. तो कौन सी चीजें हैं जो हमारे ब्लड को वापस वेन से हार्ट में जाने में अफेक्ट करती हैं, हेल्प करती हैं, और इसमें से पहला है वीनस वेल्व्स विच अलाउ द वीनस ब्लड टू फ्लो ओनली टूवर्ड्स द हार्ट. इट विल नॉट गो बैकवर्ड्स बिकॉज ऑफ द वीनस वेल्व्स. सेकेंड इज मसल कॉन्ट्रेक्शन. द मसल कॉन्ट्रेक्शन कंप्रेसिज द वेन्स इन द मसल्स एंड पुशेज सम ब्लड टूवर्ड्स द हार्ट एवरी टाइम द मसल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स. आपको पता है कि जब फौजी खड़े होते हैं परेड के लिए तो उनको बिल्कुल स्टैंड स्टिल रखना होता है, तो उस वक्त उनके जो वेन्स हैं उसमें ब्लड इतना जमा हो जाता है कि वो फिर पाउ उनके जो हैं वो सारा उसमें वेन्स में ब्लड, जब ब्लड जमा हो जाता है और उसकी वजह से उनका कार्डियक आउटपुट कम हो जाता है, कम वीनस रिटर्न होने से, और उसकी वजह से वो फेंट हो सकते हैं. तो ऐसे वक्त में उनसे कहा जाता है कि अपने काफ मसल्स को खामोशी से खड़े होकर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट करते रहें, तो जो उनके काफ मसल्स की हर कॉन्ट्रेक्शन है वो थोड़ा सा ब्लड वापस टूवर्ड्स द हार्ट पंप करती है, और उसको हम मसल कॉन्ट्रेक्शन को एक्चुअली हम पंप कहते हैं. तो देयर इज वेल्व विच प्रिवेंट्स बैक फ्लो एंड देयर इज पंप एक्टिव कॉन्ट्रेक्शन ऑफ द मसल विच पुशेज द ब्लड टूवर्ड्स द हार्ट इन द काफ मसल्स. द रेस्पिरेटरी मसल कॉन्ट्रेक्शन क्रिएट्स अ नेगेटिव इंट्राथोरेसिक प्रेशर दैट सक्स द ब्लड इनटू द हार्ट. सो ये भी एक पंप है, ये वो पंप है जो नेगेटिव प्रेशर के जरिए ब्लड को अंदर हार्ट की तरफ पंप कर रहा है. आप रेस्पिरेटरी मसल कॉन्ट्रेक्शन को अच्छी तरह पढ़ चुके हैं. यू नो दैट द इंस्पिरेटरी मसल्स व्हेन दे कॉन्ट्रैक्ट दे इंक्रीज द साइज ऑफ द चेस्ट कैविटी एंड दैट क्रिएट्स अ नेगेटिव इंट्राथोरेसिक प्रेशर. दो पंप्स आपने पढ़ लिए. अब आप देख लें, इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ वेल्व्स इफ वन ऑफ दीज टू आइटम्स, नंबर वन वाज वेल्व्स एंड द अदर वाज पंप, इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ वेल्व्स द वीनस प्रेशर इन द फीट इज प्लस 90 मिलीमीटर ऑफ मर्करी इन अ स्टैंडिंग एडल्ट ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी. द वेल्व्स एंड द पंप्स कीप द वीनस प्रेशर इन द फीट ऑफ ए वॉकिंग एडल्ट एट लेस देन प्लस 20 मिलीमीटर ऑफ मर्करी. सो द टू टुगेदर निगेट a pressure of minus of plus 70 millimeter of mercury. They undo this pressure and keep the pressure up to 20 millimeter of mercury in the leg veins, and this helps the venous return. So here you see the diagrammatic representation of different features. The veins have got valves in them and they prevent backflow. This is a deep vein. This is a superficial vein. Superficial vein has got valve in it and this prevents backflow. Deep vein has got valves in it and this prevents backflow. And the superficial veins empty into the deep veins and there are valves in the connecting veins and this prevents backflow. So the feature is deep veins will take the blood directly towards the heart. The superficial veins will empty themselves into the deep veins at different connecting points, and the valves in these veins will prevent backflow and allow the blood to pass through the deep veins into the heart. This is peripheral calf muscle which is allowing the blood to go up. Whenever it contracts, the blood is pushed upwards. The valve, and it is also pushed downwards because the muscle is compressing from outside. The downward backflow is prevented by the valve in the vein, and the forward outflow is accommodated because the valves are made such that when they are pushed from below, they will open up and they allow the blood to go up and then do not allow the blood, this blood to come back. Now we were discussing respiratory pump enhancing the venous return, and the diagrammatic representation of them is that the veins, when you are lying down and your muscle, calf muscles are not working, atmospheric pressure presses upon the veins and allows the blood to go towards the heart, and in the abdomen, when it comes into the abdomen, there is plus 6 millimeter of mercury pressure here, and it can be overcome by the respiratory pump, which is less 5 millimeter of mercury less than the atmospheric pressure. So there was atmospheric pressure here and there is pressure in the chest 5 millimeter of mercury less than the atmospheric pressure, so it is sucked inside. Veins are being pressed, peripheral veins are being pressed by atmospheric pressure, and then it is sucked inside the chest and into the right atrium by negative intrathoracic pressure. अभी तक जो आपको पढ़ाया है वो था कि नॉर्मली वेन्स का स्ट्रक्चर क्या है, उसमें वेल्व्स किस तरह हैं, उस पर पेरिफेरल मसल्स का क्या इफेक्ट होता है, उस पर रेस्पिरेटरी मसल्स का क्या इफेक्ट है होता है, और ये दोनों मिलकर ग्रेविटी को कैसे अंडू करते हैं, और राइट एट्रियल प्रेशर का क्या रोल है वीनस रिटर्न में, ये सब कुछ आपने पढ़ा। और अब हम एबनॉर्मल पर प्रेशर्स की तरफ जाएंगे कि उन्हें रिकॉर्ड कैसे करते हैं और उनकी डिस्क्रिप्शन कैसे करते हैं। सो द जुगुलर वीनस पल्स, आप अगर जुगुलर वेन के बारे में जानते हैं तो ठीक है, नहीं तो आपके लिए ये जो आप कोई गाना गा रहा हो या कोई और लंबी सी आवाज़ निकाल रहा हो तो आपको नज़र आता है कि जो गर्दन की लेटरल साइड पर वेन है वो फूल गई है, दैट इज़ एक्सटर्नल जुगुलर वेन, उसका नाम जुगुलर वेन है। एक इंटरनल जुगुलर वेन भी होती है दैट इज़ लाइंग बीनीथ द मसल्स एंड इज़ नॉट यूजुअली विजिबल टू यू पीपल नॉर्मली। सो द जुगुलर वीनस पल्स इज द ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ राइट एट्रियल प्रेशर चेंजेस बैकवर्ड इन टू द सेंट्रल वेन्स, एंड because the jugular veins are the nearest to the heart among the visible veins, the pulsations seen in it are called jugular venous pulse. Actually, it is representing the right atrial pressure changes in the body. So how do we record this jugular venous pressure? We put the patient on a couch and then put a pillow under the head so that the head is slightly flexed as compared to the straight body, and it should have a 30 degrees to the horizontal position. So what we see is during atrial systole we see a big bounding A wave. This is the period of atrial systole. Then we see a wave C. We observe a wave C during isovolumetric contraction, because both the valves are closed, and during these closed valves and with these closed valves the ventricle is contracting. So the AV valve bulges into the right atrium and produces a pressure. Wave V is another upstroke seen in the later stages of the ventricular systole, and that is because the AV valves have been closed and the atrial filling is occurring all during the systole, and it has increased the amount of blood in the atrium to increase some pressure in it. There is a descent Y, there is a descent X during between C and V, and because the ventricle has emptied itself, because of that the AV valve is now dropped into the ventricle because of suction of the AV valves into the ventricle, and this has produced decrease in the pressure in the right atrium, and this is called X descent. Descent Y occurs when the right atrium empties itself into the ventricle during ventricular diastole. This is the late ventricular diastole, this portion, and this is the early ventricular diastole. And during early ventricular diastole, when the isovolumetric relaxation stops and the AV valves open up, there is a decrease in the atrial pressure, and this is seen as the Y descent. So now we see it in the scenario of an MCQ. These are 5 points, and any of these 5 description can be given, saying that this is PR interval, or this is ventricular systole, or this is ventricular diastole, and this and that. So A C interval, A is here, C is here. You see it is representing PR interval. C V interval, this is C, this is V, and this is representing ventricular systole. VC interval, this is V and this is C, this is V here, this is V and this is C, and they are representing, what are they representing? Ventricular diastole. VY interval, this is V and this is Y, early filling. This shows rapid filling of the ventricle. YA interval, from Y to A there is delayed filling of the ventricle. That is all about it, reduced filling of the ventricle till A. So diastole ki aapki kitni stages hoti hai? Isovolumetric relaxation, usme aapke paas V aata hai, की जो जगह बनी हुई है वी वाली, उसके बाद आपके पास आती है रैपिड फिलिंग, यहाँ पर रैपिड फिलिंग हो जाती है जो ही वेल्व ओपन होता है। उसके बाद आपके पास आती है रिड्यूस्ड फिलिंग, जहाँ पर दोनों प्रेशर्स इक्वल हैं और फिलिंग हो रही है, वॉल्यूम बढ़ रहा है, डायस्टेसिस है, और ये आपका है वाई ए इंटरवल, और आपका यहाँ पर वी पॉइंट है। ये मैं आपके लिए डायग्राम में लेबल कर देती हूँ।